Welcome again to another session of Ecology and Environmental System Study with the help of GIS. In previous three sessions, we have already learnt about basics of ecology, ecosystems and biodiversity. In this last session, we will learn about uses of different advanced techniques for observation of biodiversity for its conservation. Few of the techniques which can be used for conservation are GIS, Geographic Information System, Remote Sensing, and GPS, like Global Positioning System. What are these? GIS, it is one of the system which is involves geographic component to show current information and analyze the same. It is a system which allows use of maps and images for tracking any information which we require for conservation. Remote sensing is another part which helps the satellites or aircrafts to capture images or information near the Earth's surface. And few of the times they use digital ortho images for tracking. GPS is another system which takes satellites in Earth's orbit, which can provide very precise locations on Earth's surface, which locations are expressed as latitudes and longitudes, coordinates and equivalent units. Points to be remembered in GIS are: sources of input data for GIS are remote sensing and GPS, and GIS enables storing and manipulating of input data of remote sensing and GPS. So, what is exactly Geographic Information System? Few of the authors have tried to give different information and definitions of GIS. As we can see here, Borogas in 1986, Tollison's in 1972, NCGIA in 1987 and Cowan in 1988 have tried to give different definitions of GIS. But what is the intelligent definition of GIS? It is a system of integrated computerized tools for the end-to-end processing, that is capturing, storing, retrieval, analysis and displaying of the data, using locations on the surface of Earth to create interrelation between operations management and decision making. Few points to be remembered are: GIS uses integrated tools for spatial analysis. It comprises end-to-end processing of data. It adopts explicit location on Earth's surface to relate data. And finally, this is aimed at decision support as well as scientific inquiries on ongoing operations. Importance of GIS with respect to development. Being developing nation, most of the government activities are estimated to be geographically based. Hence, few of the portals like Bhuvan, ISRO give different significance from the point of view of study of advanced techniques like GIS. Our point of interest is related to ecology and biodiversity, as we have already learned that. So, needed information can be seen with the help of this particular GIS data model. What is GIS data model and what is the purpose of GIS data model? This model allows geographic features in real world location which can be represented digitally. Real world locations and geographic features can be represented digitally, stored as a database for presenting there in an analog form, that is map, that is abstract representation of real life data. So, GIS data model is divided into different layers. Each element can be represented as each layer, like hydrology, topography, land use, utilities, soil, street, district, places. Each layer, when combines together, it will give us exact map, abstract map of that particular location on Earth. So, for biodiversity study, ISRO has developed one portal known as Bhuvan, Indian Geo Platform by ISRO. Bhuvan is very active in giving various information related to India, like climate and environment, thematic studies, disaster services, ocean services, clean Ganga, flood warming, census data, environment and forest, NVIS, CRIS, and so on. You can observe all the remaining options in the given snapshot. Few important things about Bhuvan. It is a software application that allows users to explore 2D and 3D representations of Earth's surface. This browser is specially tailored to view India, offering the highest resolutions in Indian region. The content provided in Bhuvan is available in local 4 languages. Apart from visualization, Bhuvan provides services for domestic and international supports for disaster management, satellite data free of cost, and products download facilities also available, which has rich thematic database. Bhuvan is using crowdsourcing approach majorly to enrich maps and collect points from the data of our interest, and it acts as a platform for hosting government data. Again, ISRO has developed one special portal for study of biodiversity in India, that is Biodiversity Information System. Indian Institute of Remote Sensing governs this particular portal, which gives you required information related to all biodiversity present in Indian regions, like vegetation type, fragmentation, disturbance index, and biological richness are the few points which you can observe on the portal of BIS. So, here we are giving some satellite images which we can observe on this Bhuvan site as well as BIS site. Here in this image you can observe tracking of particular location. We can observe that we have tracked location of Maharashtra state with the pink line, and in which we can observe the presence of water bodies. Tracking is nothing but marking limits of particular location which is of our interest. This is the snapshot which shows wildlife sanctuaries and national parks in India. Again, one more image giving information about natural parks and sanctuaries. This snapshot gives major information about national parks present in South India. This image gives us information about tiger projects which are ongoing in India related to biodiversity conservation. This project gives elephants conservation projects ongoing in India. Another NVIS, Environmental Information System portal on Bhuvan, giving information about estuaries in coast of India. Fisheries and centers, fishery centers present on coast of India. Mangroves present. This is a BIS image giving information about biological richness of India on state level basis. This is about the last session. If you have any doubts, you can contact us on prescribed email ID below this video. Thank you so much.